In the next exercise, we will develop two models using linear static analysis to determine the maximum vertical displacement and stresses in the soil due to the transmitted loads by two footings. Both models will be resolved with solid 3D structural elements. The geotechnical reports indicate that the clay solid can support as maximum vertical stresses 5 kilopounds per square centimeter, and the structure can assume a maximum vertical displacement of 2 centimeters. The first model consists of two isolated footings, the first one with an eccentric column and the second one centered. The square columns only transmit vertical loads. The second model is the proposed solution where the first model does not meet the geotechnical requirements. It adds a strap beam between the footings, assuring that both of them works as a unique element. This is the first model that we'll do. Let's create a new document, 3D, static and structural. And we'll start with geometry. First of all, we can change the units choosing here user units, centimeters in length and kilonewtons in force. So once we have explained the problem data, let's begin with the geometry description. We will use two different processes to create it. First of all, the foundations are defined by using primitive shapes, then choosing box and defining it by two points. This method allows us to insert two opposite points that define the box. Okay, so we create foundation one. You can see the point coordinates in the documents that we have sent you. We start, the first point is 0, 0, 0, and the second point is 225, 300, and 95. Control enter to do OK and next, and we enter foundation 2. The first point is 470, 0, 0, and the second point is 770, 395. Okay, and now we have the foundations. To create the columns above the foundations and the soil below them, we will use the command extrusion. All that we need is to define a surface and a path. As the surface follows the path, it will become a volume. So we create the surface using quad by 4 points and create surface column 1. The first point is 0, 130, 95. The second point is 0, 170, 95. The third one, 40, 170, 95. And the fourth one, 40, 130, and 95. Control más enter. And we follow the same process. Now that we have created surface column 1, surface column 2, and surface solid, we will create an axis as the path for the extrusion. X-axis, okay, a new y-axis. Okay, a new and Z axis. Now that we have created the surface and the axis, we will go to geometry, extrude, partial length. We will call it column 1 extrusion, select set axis, 300 centimeters as height, and geometric entities, surface column 1 and surface column 2. I select both of them while pressing Ctrl to select all of them. Control new, and then we create the soil extrusion, selecting y-axis 900 centimeters as height, and geometric entities surface soil. Now we have the geometry defined, and we need to create the materials. There will be only two of them, a low plasticity clay soil and a concrete material. So we select soil, soil type, clay low plasticity. We leave the name. You can see the parameters, the soil, and the next one, concrete, we will call it C2530, error code 2, and we select the concrete. Nice. Now that we have the geometry and the material, we have to define the structural elements. We'll use all the created geometry to shape the solid 3D structural elements. Starting with the columns, go to Mesh tab, select solid, name it column 1 solid 3D, material the concrete one, geometry select both columns and press OK. We can change the name, because if we create both structural elements at once, it will assign it a default name. So we will call it column 1 and column 2. Now that we'll have created the material and the geometry, we'll use the created geometry to shape the solid 3D structural elements. Another thing that is useful is that when we create both elements at once, it will assign them a default name. We can change it going to properties panel and simply doing this. Nice. Now we select both structural elements and apply them mesh controls, selecting extrude surface mesh, quadrangle, advancing front, and 20 centimeters as this size. We will repeat this process with the foundations and the soil. So we go to solid, we call it foundation 1, solid 3D, same material, and the geometries will be the foundation ones. So we change the name following the one that is reflected in geometry. And then the same process. Select the foundations, control extrude surface mesh, thirty centimeters as extrude size, quadrangle as element type, advancing front as algorithm, and 50 centimeters at edge size. And then at last we will create the soil solid, changing the material to clay low plasticity, selecting the geometry, and then applying the mesh controls, extrude surface mesh, which is as extrude size 50 centimeters, quadrangle, advancing front, and 50 centimeters as edge size. Then we need to add local control by curves and select the bottom curve in this surface, in the front surface. And then go to local mesh controls, expand it, select control by length, and choosing 196 as length. Okay, perfect. Now that the structural elements are defined, we will mesh out, saving it as excerpt 11, and then waiting for the process to finish. Nice. Now that we have it, let's use the contact tab. In this exercise, we will use two contact types, glue type and touching type. The glue type means that the contacted elements can be separated, being similar to an unique body. The touching type means that they are not attached, although there is some friction between them. This friction depends on the body roughness. So we have the glue type between column and foundations, and the friction time between the soil and the foundations. So we will call it column footing, and then select contacted, foundation 1, foundation 2. Don't forget to press Ctrl to select two or more elements. And then the contacting one, column 1, column 2. We press OK. Interaction properties, glue contact. OK, nice. And then we'll do it again, but using the touching type. We call it soil footing, contacted, foundation 1, foundation 2. Contacting soil. Press OK. Go to interacting properties and change it to touching contact. We need to select the friction coefficient, that is 0.56. Okay, now we need to define the loads. The next step is applying loads to the columns. They are centered and located in the top of the columns. So we create loads, load groups, we call it the structural loads by defect. And then add single loads, we will call it Q1. The structural elements, column 1, points 20, 150 and 395. Direction minus 1 in the set coordinate points and load 1600. Nice. Okay, and new, and then we'll create Q2. Selecting column 2 as structural element, and as point we will introduce 620, 150, 395. The same direction as earlier. And we have kilonewtons. You can come to the loads tab and select it to plot them and assure you that their position is okay. And then we will add the boundary conditions, selecting surface. This means that these boundary conditions will restrict a whole surface at the movements that we have to do it. So we call it EC1, a structural element solid 3D, selecting only two surfaces, and these ones will be constructed at x-axis, so we don't let them to move like this. Then we follow the same process. We wait. The other constraints, this surface and this surface, constructed at y-axis. And then the last one, the bottom surface, constructed at movement seat. Now that we have the loads and the boundary conditions, we go to load case, call it load case, it's okay, and we have the loads, structural loads, with a factor of 1, and boundary conditions 4. Now we have defined the load case. As you can see, you can select on mesh to see all the constraints that we have. And then we need to configure the solver and select check F convergence. This tolerance will be changed to 0.1. Contact method segment to segment, Initial contact detection and create incremental results. And then we can solve it. Now that the first model is defined, it's time to go back to the geotechnical requirements and check them in order to assure that the model satisfies the exercise premises. So come to the results tab, select load case 6, displacement and rotations, and then set component of displacement. Select average and plot it. 2.6 centimeters, it's more than the requirements limit. And then go to stresses, set component of stress, and select kilopounds per square centimeter, average 2. Then hide the structural elements above the soil, and you can see that we have 5.4 is more too. As we can see, the specifications are not fulfilled in vertical displacement conditions nor set stresses, because the displacement limit was 2 centimeters and the existing displacement in our structure is 2.6. Same situation with the set stresses. Talking about contact status, select contact in here. Contact status. Upload it. And now we'll hide the soil and show the structures. Talking about contact status, it's important to know that 1 means that the bodies are full contact, and 0 means that they are separated. When we analyze contact status, we can see that there is a zone with no more in contact with the soil. This one. So we need to change it. To solve it, we will introduce model 2. As the first model didn't meet the requirements, we have designed another proposal to fix it. A strap beam that connects the footings. The idea behind this model is making the footings work as one, centering the soil reactions and distributing them under the structure. Instead of introducing fixed values to create the beam geometry, we will define them as variables. The reason behind this procedure is that we could fail while setting the beam dimensions, not meeting the requirements. Rather than making the whole design again, we can easily change the variables, making it a faster process. So we go to parameter list and adds 2 variables. First one, the height. And we give it 95 centimeters, and then adding 1 more, calling it W white, and giving it a value of 60 centimeters. Once we have this, we can go to geometry, and then we will create, same as earlier, a quadrilateral. Go to properties panel and then select strap beam surface and select the points. And here, instead of the set coordinate, we will put HE. and you can see that the parameters is set automatically. Same process with the second one, and here 105 minus each. Third one, 225, then 120 plus the white, and 105 minus 80, and then we will finish defining the beam with this point, and then we click OK, and we will extrude it as the geometry of the columns. So we will call it strap beam extrusion through the X axis with a height of 245. Select strap beam surface and click OK, and then we need to model it creating a solid beam strap solid 3D, selecting concrete material, it's okay like this, and selecting the geometry of the strap beam, and then that we have it, we need to add the mesh controls, extrude surface, and then we will select 20 centimeters as extrude size, quadrangle as element type, advancing front, and another 20 centimeters as edge size, and then we will mesh it. Now that we have meshed the beam strap, don't forget to add the contacts between the beam and the foundations, because if you don't add it, it's like the beam is alone above the soil. So we go to contact, column footing, and select as contacting the beam strap too. We need to edit it by picking and select it. Press OK. And now they are contacting. So hold it, and then we come to results tab, show load case 6, and we'll go one by one. First, displacement and rotations, set component of displacement. We can see that we have 1.885 centimeters, so we meet the geotechnical requirements. Stresses, set component of stress, kilopounds per square centimeter, remember to choose average, activate it, and then we will hide these structural elements. You can plot the deformed one if you want to, I like it personally. And now we can see that we have 3.5 kilopounds per square centimeter, that it's much better than the model one. We meet the requirements. and at last we select contact. Contact the status and plot it. And now we hide the soil and select the foundations. As you can see, they are not separated. They are working perfectly. So our solution was good. Thank you for seeing this webinar, and I expect to see you soon. Bye.